TI's latest line of power sourcing equipment, aka PSE controllers, provide a robust way of delivering power to loads using power over Ethernet. In this video, we'll discuss some benefits of TI's PSEs, show you how to select the correct PSE controller based on your system requirements, and show you how to get started using our evaluation boards and reference designs. This video requires some basic understanding of how a PoE system works. If you're new to PoE, first, check out our video training series at the following link. Power over Ethernet, aka PoE, is a widely adopted and fast-growing method of powering various loads, such as IP cameras, wireless access points, building lighting, and digital signage. Our PoE solutions are IEEE 802.3BT compliant, solidifying interoperability, and come with plenty of design resources to aid your development. We'll look at these later. We are involved in designing both PSEs and powered devices, or PDs, giving further assurance in interoperability, which leads us to the biggest problems in the PoE space. Two of the foremost problems in PoE are interoperability between the PSE and the PD, and the management of high port count systems. Port power management becomes important when the power supply is not able to support all ports on max load. TI has been at the forefront in addressing these issues. We are a member of the Ethernet Alliance Committee, which plays an integral role in certifying interoperable devices. We also provide our own turnkey PSE system-level software, known as Firm PSE, which reduces time to market and frees up valuable software resources by enabling real-time communication with the system and customization of firmware. This design supports power management with priority, multiple power supplies, legacy PD detection, field upgradability, UART I2C communication with the host, dynamic power, and more. These features can be configured with the Firm PSE GUI. With Firm PSE, you won't have to worry about the hassle of writing code to control your PSEs. TI has an extensive line of reference designs and evaluation modules, allowing users to test PSE performance in their systems. These designs often serve as a template for users developing PSE-driven equipment, such as Ethernet switches, greatly reducing design cycles for PSE customers. We'll look at these soon. Let's begin by looking at how to select the correct PSE. When selecting a PSE, three big considerations come into play: power level, channel count, and the need for system-level software. These will vary for customers based on their power needs and the number of loads being powered. Software becomes important when you want control over how much power is sourced from each PSE port and the priority of the port, i.e., port power management. It also enables firmware customization. If you don't want to write code to create software, you'll want to get a PSE that supports TI's Firm PSE solution. We'll show you these PSEs soon. With all this in mind, let's check out TI's parametric search tool, which can help you find the PSE that best fits your needs. On the PoE landing page, click View All Products. From here, scroll down to the filters. Click Power Sourcing Equipment. Then, click View Parts. To view different power levels of PSEs, scroll down to the PoE standard supported. Choose a standard commensurate to the power level you desire. If you are unsure which standards support which power levels, go to our training series using the link mentioned earlier in the video. You can also choose the number of ports desired as follows. Next, let's look at the following flowchart to determine which of our latest PSEs works best for you. Begin by considering your power needs. If you need more than 30 watts of power, the TPS23881 will be the best match. It is compatible with Firm PSE software and has 8 channels. Again, Firm PSE is our turnkey software solution for implementing firmware customization and port power management. If you need 30 watts of power or less, you need to consider what channel count you need. If you need 4 channels or less, the TPS23861 is the best match. It comes with autonomous mode. Autonomous mode allows the PSE to operate without an external host controller and without system software. This is best for systems in which the power supply is sufficient for powering all ports on max load. In other words, port power management is not needed. In such cases, using autonomous mode can drastically simplify your system design. If you need more than 4 channels, you can choose between the TPS-23882 and the TPS-23882B1. Both PSEs have 8 channels and are compatible with firm PSE. The main difference is that the TPS-23882B1 also has autonomous mode, while the TPS-23882 does not. This gives the TPS-23882B1 more flexibility. It can support systems that both do and don't need system-level software. Before we help you find the right design resources, let's clarify something about our product selection page. You'll notice that there are other PSEs besides those mentioned in the flowchart. Don't let these confuse you. These are just older PSEs that some customers still use in their designs. The PSEs in the flowchart are our new and hero devices. Some of the PSEs you'll see have been replaced by those shown in the flowchart. For example, the TPS-23881 replaced the TPS-23880. The TPS-23882 replaced the TPS-23888. And the TPS-23861 replaced both the TPS-23884 and the TPS-23841. Now, let's look at the reference designs and evaluation modules we offer for each PSE. Before we show you what resources we have, begin by considering how much development you want over your design. Do you want a design that is nearly ready to go that you can copy and paste? Or do you want more control over your design, giving you more configuration options for hardware and software? Do you need system-level software for firmware customization and port power management? And if so, do you want to develop it yourself or instead use TI's GUI configurable firm PSE solution? With this in mind, let's look at the resources for each PSE, beginning with the TPS-23881. You'll notice there are 3 categories for the resources we offer. The Evaluation Module, or EVM Design column, showcases resources that are geared towards more general use of the PSE. These resources tend to give you more control over your design. The TI Design column showcases reference designs for specific applications. These resources tend to be more plug-and-play, requiring less development from the user. The Technical Documentation column provides you with a list of technical documents that will help you better understand the features of the given PSE and aid you in designing systems with that PSE. If you're looking for more control over your design, the TPS-23881 has lots of EVM design resources. You can use the following motherboard and daughter card, either with the following EVM GUI or a host controller like the following MSP430 microcontroller, but not both. The EVM GUI is geared towards testing purposes and allows you to monitor the port statuses of the EVM design. You'll need the USB to any adapter to interface between the GUI and the EVM board. If you want to create your own system-level software, you'll need to use a host controller, like the MSP430 MCU. TI provides you with reference code to get you started on creating your own software. For a more plug-and-play solution, we have the TI design. This comes with the following reference design along with the firm PSE GUI and software. It also comes with a host interface protocol user's guide that can be accessed from the Secure Resources folder. We'll show you this soon. The reference design comes with a motherboard, the TPS-23881 PSE daughter card, and an MCU daughter card, which is used to evaluate the firm PSE software. The firm PSE GUI gives you plenty of configuration options for the software. You can use dynamic power, prioritize power delivery to some ports over others, etc. With these resources, you won't need to create any system-level software. Firm PSE takes care of this. You can learn more about designing with the TPS-23881 by looking through the documents in the Technical Documentation column. Here, you can learn about port power management, how to choose the correct software solutions, how to load SRAM and parity check code over I2C, view test reports on the PSE, and learn about design solutions for high port count system, amongst other things. You can easily find these resources on our website, including the technical documents, by searching the exact names and part numbers shown in the table in your search engine. Now, moving on to the TPS-23882. These resources are nearly identical in functionality to the resources pertaining to the TPS-23881, except they have different part numbers. For this reason, they will not be covered in detail, but feel free to pause the video. I'll just note that like the TPS-23881, the TPS-23882 has a reference design that is compatible with Firm PSE. Next, let's look at the TPS-23861. For more general testing equipment, the EVMs will be useful. Like before, you can either use the EVM board with the EVM GUI or with the following MCU. To use the GUI, you'll need the USB to GPIO adapter module. If you decide you want to use the MCU and create your own software, we provide reference code for both basic and multi-port power management applications. This PSE also comes with two different reference designs, each for different use cases. The first reference design showcases a single port system. Some customers are interested in designing a system with only one port, so we provide this reference design. The second reference design is specialized for lightning surge protection. This can be important for PSEs operating in certain environments. Under technical documentation, you'll find some documents on the benefits of autonomous mode, the importance of lightning surge protection, and PSE PCB layout, amongst many other things. And lastly, let's take a look at the resources for the TPS-23882B1. This PSE does not have any reference designs. However, it is pin-to-pin compatible with the TPS-23882 and is also compatible with Firm PSE. Also, note that again, the TPS-23882B1 can be operated in autonomous mode. The remaining resources showcased are very similar to those pertaining to the TPS-23882 and will thus not be covered in detail. Again, feel free to pause the video. And now, let's look at how to find these resources on the TI site. Again, start with our PoE landing page and click View All Products. We'll use the TPS-23881 as an example. To view all the technical documents, simply click on the Technical Documentation tab. To view the EVMs and reference designs, click on the Design and Development tab. Under Hardware Development, you'll find some of the components for both the EVMs and the reference designs. Under Software Development, you'll be able to access both the GUI for the EVM and the MCU reference code. To view the reference designs, click the Reference Design tab. Let's look at this reference design. This page will give you a list of all the resources, both hardware and software, to get started. There's also a step-by-step guide for how to get started with this reference design. Finally, let me show you how to get access to the Firm PSE firmware, GUI, and Host Protocol User's Guide. You'll need to request access to the Secure Resources folder. If you haven't already done so, create a TI account. Once you've logged in, click on your account as follows. Click on the My Secure Resources tab. From here, you'll be able to request access, and once you have access, your page will look like mine. And then, you can access the resources by simply clicking this button. You can also get free debugging and design assistance from our experts on TI's E2E Forum. Go to e2e.ti.com. Thanks for watching.